John Crestani here, and I'm going to be talking about some marketing that crossed the line here. There's three marketers in particular that the U.S. is going to be sending to jail because their ads were so effective, but they went over the line. The first ad we're going to be looking at here is a fake COVID relief ad that was used to sell cars. The first part of this marketing, if you look at the first letter, they sent out these packages to people in the mail in their local area, and these ads worked extremely well, but they worked too well, and they got them in extreme trouble because they didn't disclose their financial terms correctly. They faked COVID relief, and amongst other items, they had all sorts of problems here. Now, the first part of this ad, you'll see it looks like a real official government document. This is a highly effective tool that you can use in marketing, is making your ads blend in with something that has a lot of credibility. You see this on TV sometimes, where it looks, where you think you're watching a public service announcement because it's got the same style, but it's really an ad. Or you think you're watching a news show, but it's really an infomercial or an ad. I did this in TV where my ad, which is a 30-minute long TV infomercial, it looks like you're watching the news, but it's really an ad for my book. That isn't illegal, but in this case, faking that it is actually a medical relief, okay, it's very different. You can make your ads look like a government public service announcement somewhat, or the news somewhat, but not all the way, and not medical relief. And in this case, these marketers went way over the line, but they continue to go over the line. When you look, they actually show a fake check. Now, this is another tried and true marketing tactic that is very effective. And I don't think there's anything illegal about sending what appears to be a fake check. But when you are making your check look like it is an actual government stimulus for a deadly medical condition, medical issues and the FTC do not work out well. And this has an FTC case from the Federal Trade Commission, which is the commission that governs marketers out here in the US. They went over the line. Also, you'll see that even their disclosures, they don't let you know the actual financing. All the numbers are fake. They don't include any of the fees. They're advertising what the product costs, but it doesn't really cost that much. These guys are just trying to get you to get on the car lot. They're selling used cars. They just want you to get on the lot so they can hard close you there. They don't really care if their advertising has any modicum of truth in it. That's why these guys are getting sued by the US government and possibly taken to jail or their business shut down or fined a lot of money. This is a federal case. The other thing you'll see that these marketers did, again, they must have had a very aggressive marketer working for them, is they have a ton of Facebook postings for cars. Now, if you're selling used items in your local community, that Facebook's marketplace might be a good place for you to consider to market. And I have another video where I teach people how to use the Facebook marketplace to actually generate leads. There's a lot of stuff you can do with Facebook's traffic in the marketplace to make money as a marketer. But in this case, this was all false advertising. You didn't actually have to put no money down. There's all sorts of hidden fees and hidden charges. And whenever you're messing with both the financial system, you're lying about financial stuff, and you're lying about, especially lying about financial stuff where you're charging people money and hidden fees and all this stuff, that's a big no-no with the Federal Trade Commission. And the other one is just anything medical related with false claims or really hijacking the trust and credibility of the US government will land you in a lot of problems very fast. So this marketer, even though it seems like they have some good marketers on their team that know the right stuff, they're messing around in the wrong field, which is with hidden fees and fake medical relief. Big no-nos, Let's go on to the next one. Now, this next ad is from a very large company, and this is a very large FTC case that is being preceded, which is for LendingClub, which is a lead generation company for mortgage officers and mortgage and refinance companies. That is, for those of you not in the US, that means home loans. So this is a company that is generating interested people's information, and then they're selling their data to actual home loan companies. We're talking big money here, hundreds and hundreds of thousands, if not millions of dollars, that each of these mortgages or refinancings are worth. So it's a big chunk of change. And in this case, they're just trying to get high conversion rates. I mean, that's how these companies work. When you're generating leads, you want the highest conversion rate possible. But these marketers cross the line because they claim there's no hidden fees. But once again, they're running into trouble because there are hidden fees and LendingClub is failing to disclose them, or they disclose them in fine print way too far down. And when you're dealing with credit and complex financial instruments and you're not disclosing things properly, that will land you in a lot of trouble with the government, as is the case here. And furthermore, they are saying in order to get people to give them all their information so they can sell the leads for more, they're saying everybody qualifies for a loan. When in reality, it's just marketing. There is nothing on the website that is actually checking if these folks are qualifying for this actual loan. It's just a marketing tactic to get more information so they can sell more data. And that's a big no-no. I used to market mortgages myself. That was the last job before I became a full-time internet marketer. And I was marketing mortgages, and there's a lot of regulations when you're dealing with large amounts of money and complex financial instruments that need to be abided by, and you can't make wrong steps when you're doing that. Now, after I got out of marketing mortgages and I started working for myself, I was marketing an investment company. And once again, there's a lot of regulations. There's a lot of money there, right? Because when you're dealing with the financial system, there's just endless streams of money changing hands. And really all you need to do is just poke your head up, stick your hand in, and just catch a few dollars, because there's so much money flowing through loans and investments. It's insane. And I made almost over $500,000 marketing the investment company as an affiliate. And that was the first year or two of my career as an affiliate marketer. Now, if you want to learn more about affiliate marketing and the business I did to, or and I still do, to make a lot of money, and how I built my wealth, and I now own 2 acres, huge property in Malibu. I built a really incredible life, and I'm really proud of it. You can go in the links in the description. You can see where you can sign up for a free training for Super Affiliate System, which is my training program. I've trained tens of thousands of folks to earn their first dollars online and become affiliate marketers. We do everything the legal and compliant ways. I don't teach these fast methods that will land you in jail, because marketing is a regulated thing around the world, and you just can't make false claims. And in this case, the LendingClub was trying to make a quick buck at the expense of people, really. Now, this last case, which is being investigated and prosecuted by the US government, the Federal Trade Commission, is for another large company named Tapjoy, and they partner with mobile app companies to show ads and sell virtual rewards and whatnot. But the problem here is that they did not disclose hidden fees. Once again, the government and governments around the world hate when you go out and you market products and you play around with people's finances and you're not upfront about what something costs and how many payments you will receive. Your credit card will get dinged. In this case, this is somewhat similar to LendingClub, whereas Tapjoy is an intermediary for a lot of other different companies. They say, buy this product to get virtual rewards that you can use in the game. And they've partnered with a bunch of other companies, dozens or hundreds of other companies, to create signups. Now, this can be an effective way to create signups, but the problem here is that Tapjoy didn't look into the companies that were advertising on their platform, and many of them had hidden fees. And the problem is the government doesn't care that even if Tapjoy, you know, claims to be just an intermediary, Tapjoy says, oh no, it's not. You know, it's these other companies that have the hidden fees. We just allow them to advertise on our platform and people kind of sign up. It doesn't matter in the government's case because in their mind, Tapjoy was enabling these companies to actually defraud the public, and that doesn't fly. And same thing in Lending Club. Lending Club is just generating leads for these other home loan companies. Hey, it wasn't us, right? We're just an intermediary. Doesn't really fly because they are expected to do their due diligence. And as a marketer, it's important to know this because even as a marketer, you could say, oh, I'm just marketing the company,
nope.
But it's up to you to know, okay, did somebody do their due diligence here? You know, that's why I like to work with long-term affiliate networks that are established and do due diligence for me so I don't have to go through all those pains. And that's why I use ClickBank and DigiStore because those are long-standing affiliate networks. ClickBank is possibly the oldest affiliate network online. They were created in 1998 and they vet all their companies and they make them go through compliance checks before they allow you to market products. I've made millions of dollars through ClickBank. I have an affiliate program on ClickBank called Super Affiliate System, and you can earn $500 for every sale on there. Great training program, link is in the description. And I hope you enjoyed this video, kind of showing another side of marketing of what you don't wanna do. You don't wanna get in trouble. You don't wanna do these bad things when you're starting your business. So make sure you have all the information you need to make sure you're going the straight and narrow path. You wanna earn your money and not have to look behind you to see if you're gonna keep it. You wanna sleep well at night. So make sure when you start marketing, when you start your home-based business, whether that's, you know, learning affiliate marketing from me, or whether that's learning how to sell on Amazon from somebody else, or learning how to drop ship using Shopify, whatever you do, I do encourage you to get training because there are so many ins and outs of this world nowadays, and there's a lot of regulation. And get your training from somebody who actually addresses some of these topics, because I see a lot of marketers, I see a lot of gurus and trainers that really talk zero about the legal ramifications of selling products online. And the reality is that we exist in a world where there are rules, where there are laws, and in order to be a good citizen, just a good person, you should abide by them. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a thumbs up. Give me a hoorah in the comments. Hit that subscribe and notification bell. Any questions you have about any of this, or even if you enjoyed the video, or if you hate the video, or you think I should discuss different topics about these cases, let me know in the comments below. I really value all your feedback and I read your comments. And thank you for participating in learning to create your own success. So I'll see you in my next video. Bye.